Carey Price only has played in one career game seven. It was when the Bruins ran out of gas at the end of the race. They threatened Montreal in 2008 but couldn't get to the finish line. Tim Thomas is playing in his third career game seven. He has yet to win one.
Straight ahead, forecheck, and then Bergeron with a great opportunity on a stop move, taking the feed from Recchi.
Boychuk threw it in front of it off a skate. Here's Marchand off the bottom of the circle. Boychuk's blast scores! A Johnny Rocket! It's 1-0 Boston!
Just the way you want to start the game. Everybody involved. Now the Bergeron line on the ice. Great play by Marchand, playing like a veteran here in his first postseason. Protects the puck well. Finds a little lane under the stick in order to get it back to Boychuk. Love the lateral move along the blue line. It creates a better shooting lane and a net front presence of Patrice Bergeron.
Plekanec and Krejci. Bouncing puck in the slot. Horton nudges it to the circle. Lucic's back pressure takes it away from Spacek. Krejci going after him from Lucic to Krejci. Turns, saved by Price. Seidenberg's shot knocked down. Spacek chips up and out.
Those are big little plays. That result, face off in the offensive zone and a backhand short side chance for Ryder.
Bruins are out shooting Montreal 6-3 in the first 5.5 minutes of this game. Marchand back of the goal looking for Recchi. Gill around the boards. Hamrlik can't clear. Recchi out at the blue line. Has a little space. Draws Gomez. It's off Ferentz. Wiggles to the low circle. Ferentz one hands to Recchi. The shot scores! Mark Recchi! 2-0 Boston!
Well, you only get one timeout. I'll be curious if Montreal uses it right now. This place is jumping. And it's because of the Bergeron line. The whole lineup's been involved, but they've scored twice. It was Marchand that set up Boychuk. And this line again, by using their defense, Ferentz kind of fumbled the puck, but he stayed with the play. Got in there, had a nice little sweep check to free this puck, and it went right to Mark Recchi. But Recchi's where he should be, rotating out high to the high slot. He's been in game sevens before, and he's been productive. He's doing it again in his 40s. What a beautiful snapshot to the blocker side to give the Bruins a 2-0 lead.
And dangerous with Gionta in front. Boychuk goes cross corner. Ryder and Plekanec go to the corner. Plekanec goes down. Ryder's going to get a penalty here. Cooking is the call.
Well, we talked about one of the keys for Boston would be how they manage the puck coming out of their own zone. It was a nice little regroup by the Bruins. They gain the red line, go for the cross corner dump. Michael Ryder gets in his battle of strength with Thomas Plekanec. He wins that battle, but in the eyes of the officials, that was a hook. Marchand was in a good position to clear the puck.
Roman Hamrlik wires it around and rides the dasher all the way around past Campbell. Now Hamrlik, Paille playing without a stick. It's a de facto 4-on-3 if Montreal, a 5-on-3 rather, if Montreal can recognize it. Camilleri cross ice, the shot scores! Yannick Weber puts it up in the roof for the goal. It's 2-1.
Well, Paille's in a good spot. He makes the read. He's going to the wall. Just that little tap, though, he loses the stick. Now you're in trouble. The question is, do you go retrieve your stick right away? What good are you without your stick if you're not close enough to a man to eliminate him or get in the shooting lane? And Weber takes full advantage of it. That's a beautiful finishing shot, too, by a guy that doesn't play a whole lot for this club.
Hamrlik tries to cut away from Marchand, who decks Gomez, and the referee lets it go. Recchi fouls off the one-time chance on Bergeron's return pass. Now it's Campbell with re-entry. Paille going to the end boards, banging Sopel. Sopel goes down. Thornton hits him from the other side. And there's a penalty coming here. Referee Kelly Sutherland has called both penalties tonight. And then there have been other moments when he has elected to let him play.
Yeah, this one's probably going to be on Sean Thornton, who came in from the opposite side of that little scrum involving Danny Paille.
Elbowing is the call against Thornton. Sopel, it should be noted, was down on the ice lower than Thornton's elbows naturally would be.
Well, there's the hit by Paye getting it on the forecheck. Here comes Thornton from the other side, and White's in there trying to help protect with Sopel. And this looked like a pretty good hockey hit. But Sutherland's going to call him for an elbow. Thought it was a little too loose away from the body. And once again, the Canadiens back on the power play. And they're looking to tie this hockey game late in the first period with another special teams goal.
The crowd is looking at a replay on the HDX. It shows that Thornton's elbow never actually came in contact with Sopel at all. A minute to go on the penalty kill for Boston. Campbell against Subban on the end board. Gomez turns. Subban dives right in front of referee Tim Peel, and he lets it go. Kostitsyn racing up the wing. Kostitsyn back to the goal line, wheels it in front. Gomez the shot, Thomas the save. And a good face wash job by Ferentz here as Montreal continues to try to create traffic in front of Thomas.
It's embarrassing. It's embarrassing when you see a guy like Subban take the hit on the forecheck while the Canadiens are on the power play. Campbell's trying to release here. He's trying to get back into the play because the puck's free. And this is just an absolute joke. He's going to hold on to Campbell and then fall to the ice to try to get a penalty.
What is he doing?
It's embarrassing.
The expression on his face tells you everything. I'm a five-year-old kid who's about to do something that's known as misbehaving. And I deserve a timeout for that. A veteran puck rusher, he headbands the puck to Kostitsyn, bounces off, Seidenberg goes down. They're going to call a penalty on Dennis Seidenberg here? No, they're going to call one against Montreal. For what? For what? Is this for a dive? High sticker.
And this gets a rise out of the crowd, an actual penalty on Montreal. Kostitsyn tries to cut to the middle, gets his stick right in the head as he tries to avoid the body contact on a good open ice hit by Dennis Seidenberg. Stick up high, minor penalty to Kostitsyn. Only 3 seconds left on the Thornton elbow penalty.
15 seconds to go in the period. Milan Lucic for Johnny Boychuk, and a saving tap from Jeff Halpern, who is an excellent penalty killer and makes a big play there. Boychuk rotates middle of the line, draws Halpern the snapshot into Krejci. The shot flips wide off the end boards. The siren sounds. The Bruins bring the pressure to bear on Montreal, finally getting something out of a power play, if not a goal, and take a 2-1 lead into the road. Here comes Montreal into the Boston zone. Moen throwing in front. Thomas, the save and the rebound on Gionta. Bergeron with a big reach, gets a piece of the puck and then plays the body to knock down Eller. Halpern chasing against Chara. Darche goes in. Bergeron bangs him off his skates. Eller from behind. Chara goes down pretty easily. But Eller's gonna go. I don't see how the physics equation works here, and maybe Chara is reaching down to the level that he perceives from Montreal.
Now play the game.
441.
Moen behind. Boychuk. Moen steals. Fires on Thomas. A panic moment for Boston. Halfway through the penalty call against Eller. Recchi gives it away. Plekanec has a shorthanded breakaway against Thomas. He scores! The Bruins power play turning totally negative, and Montreal has tied it 2-2.
Well, this is that play that is designed to get the penalty killing unit to be standing flat-footed somewhere around their defensive blue line when the puck carrier, in this case Seidenberg, carries the puck towards the traffic and then throws a little back diagonal to Mark Recchi, but they don't connect, and all of a sudden Plekanec walks in all alone.
The calls have been rather inconsistent. Here's Horton coming off the boards, past the dot, across the front. Krejci's backhand sails over the crossbar. It may not be X and O beauty, but when you put your mind to it, here's Recchi. Took Marchand across the slot, and nobody could tap it home for the Bruins. Recchi to Bergeron, kicks to the stick. The shot saved by Price. Subban comes out off the boards. Eller the long diagonal to Halpern. Halpern in on Thomas. Saved by Thomas. Subban sinks in deep. Hammers it forward for Halpern. Boychuk unloads on Halpern. And Thomas takes the puck. And we're going to get a boarding call.
Yes, on Boychuk for the hit on Halpern into that stanchion right by Alex Ault. Subban spins away from his forecheck, and Kelly zips the puck up. And there's your hit by Boychuk. Apparently the numbers 15, too exposed. The hit from behind into the stanchion. There's your boarding call on Boychuk.
The height of drama in the Boston-Montreal series this season was when Max Pacioretty was lying unconscious at the red line at Bell Center after being hit by Zdeno Chara. Halpern telling the Montreal trainer that he's okay, that he doesn't have to go to the quiet room for 15 minutes. Probably said, what are you, nuts? It's game seven. I don't care if my brain's leaking out my ear. I'm staying on the bench.
Absolutely. This hit too much from behind by Boychuk.
Plekanec to Gionta. Montreal looking for the lead on the power play, which has been its best weapon of the series. Wisniewski to Subban on the drive. Glove save, Thomas.
Late in the second period, tied 2-2, game seven, power play Montreal. There's your one-timer.
5 seconds to go in the period. McQuaid puts it forward to Kelly. And the siren sounds to end the second period. Well, what else would you want? Game seven. Now here comes Bergeron up ice, Marchand on his left. Bergeron with Recchi the trailer. Hamrlik pokes it away. Bergeron keeps possession. McQuaid's drive, save, rebound. Recchi, two chances, three chances. Hit the post.
Protect it, lay it back for a one-timer. There's the hard drive by McQuaid. Just bothered enough by Wisniewski on the initial try by Recchi. It's there for him. Little tie up in the hands.
Plays it around. Eller closing on Marchand. The puck gets past Marchand. Eller controls to the line. Marchand blocks it with his skates. Tries to dribble it through to Bergeron. Meanwhile, down at the other end of the ice, Jeff Halpern very slow to get up and stumbling down. Halpern is a guy who took the shot from Boychuk that was ruled boarding earlier in the game and said he was okay. This time, one would think that he's going to have to go back to the quiet room for 15 minutes.
Yeah, he had some lower body injuries late in the season, missed a lot of games down the stretch. Had a little incidental contact, I believe, with Andy Ferentz down low. Ferentz actually knew he was there, kind of leaned into him a little bit. I thought this was lower body, but by the looks of that, it might be upper body. Yeah, it was a subtle little hit by Andy Ferentz away from the play. Something's been happening all series long. Top of your screen, 15 in white. There's that little shoulder. Halpern's got to be aware of what's going on. It's not like he extended the shoulder or the arm or the elbow.
Ferentz gives it away to Gomez. Back of the goal, centering pass. Kelly is there. It was just out of Mullen's reach. Kelly bangs into Hamrlik, who goes down on his face, trying to draw a call. Peverly to Ferentz. The shot bounces. The rebound scores! Chris Kelly! Hamrlik is yelling at the ref. It's not going to work! He dove one time too many!
Well, the stick of Kelly definitely comes up in the contact with Hamrlik, but not enough for any kind of a penalty call. And the Bruins kept the play moving forward. Once again, the defense jump into the play. Ferentz's drive makes its way to the front of the net, and that's exactly where Kelly goes. You talk about greasy goals and dirty areas. That's where Kelly is. Rebound chance on a shot that was knocked down. He slides it under Carey Price. The Bruins have the lead again.
Gionta off the strings. Boychuk bangs into Gionta. Ferentz brings it out the right side, deafening a TD Garden. Ferentz indirect behind Marchand. Hamrlik. Bergeron to Recchi, saved by Price. Carey Price saves the season for Montreal. Let's go Bruins at TD Garden. Gionta flips the puck over the line. Gomez's shot blocked as Ryder gets his body in the way. Kelly's behind the D. Chris Kelly on Carey Price. Saved by Price off the roof of the net, and it bounces over the back. Carey Price twice has saved Montreal's season.
maybe three times. What a nice back check by Michael Ryder. The presence of mind to just tip it back into the neutral zone, and that's where Kelly was.
Ferentz slices through the seam to Ryder. Ryder on the bouncing puck to Bergeron. The shot, same place. Rebound Bergeron. Back to Carvalet. Doesn't get much on it. He snaps the stick in two. Both teams have used their timeouts. Kostitsyn lifts Chara's stick. Chara fights it through Camilleri, but the puck comes to Wisniewski. Tees it up the drive. Save Thomas. Rebound is loose. Camilleri tries to flip it up and over. Here's Plekanec. The shot knocked down in front. McQuaid finds it in his equipment. Bergeron hacks at it. Recchi keeps it inside the line. Recchi's shot. Oh, what a save by Price! Carey Price! Price saving the season for the Montreal Canadiens. Wisniewski picks up the puck. Wisniewski back to his goal. Bergeron attacking the puck all the way. And there's a penalty coming here. High stick against Patrice Bergeron. Getting it up in James Wisniewski's face. 2:37 to go. Can your gut grind any more than this?
We just talked about it. Continue to make plays and stay out of the penalty box. Bergeron's putting some pressure on Wisniewski. He knows he's an injured guy. He's having a difficult time skating. He tries to reach around and lift his stick, and just in the general vicinity of the head, and that's going to be helpful. Smart move by Wisniewski to throw the neck back to make sure the attention was on the high stick. Close enough. Bergeron goes to the box. Canadians on the power play.
Wisniewski up to the attacking line. Camilleri across the line. Kelly takes the tap pass. It's Plekanec to Subban. He scores! PK Subban on a rocket over the glove side of Tim Thomas. A late power play pays dividends for Montreal once again, and it is 3-3 with less than 2 minutes to go.
Well, the Canadians quickly turn this puck off after the clear by Seidenberg. Camilleri is just going to post up at the offensive blue line, able to slip that puck in order to maintain possession, and now they have something going that they want, and that's a cross-corner pass back diagonal to a wide-open Subban.
Al Gill at his own line. Game 7 will go to sudden death overtime at the Eastern Conference quarterfinals between the Boston Bruins and the Montreal Canadiens. Gill against Kelly. Beverly tries to fight around Subban, who uses good body position. Now flips cross ice to Brian Gionta. The Montreal captain works on Boychuk. The shot bounces around Thomas. A reflex left leg save and a puck that was going in.
Yeah, what a feeling that must be. And then you see a puck, if you're Tim Thomas, just get totally deflected. You're reading that puck, heading for the corner.
Bergeron wins the faceoff up the end boards, but Camilleri hops on it. Gives to Kostitsyn, he dances off the boards, trickles it toward Thomas.
Well, the Canadiens were in pretty good shape because of the lively bounce from behind the net. Now they're trying to get into their cycle mode, create a 2-on-1.
D position, which gives another offensive option. Kostitsyn on the off wing, the shot, St. Thomas, rebound! Just past the post as Seidenberg blocked it down. The Bruins send it the length of the rink, no icing. Weber across in front of his own goal. Montreal starting to feel pretty confident here. Gionta over the line to Gomez. The shot deflects, and Thomas makes another save. Thomas has made three stops on deflected pucks in the overtime alone. Ferentz to Ryder. You talk about season-saving stops. Tim Thomas has already had three of them. Here comes a three-on-three. Jeff Halpern stretching wide. Looks at Gomez. It jumped the line. The crowd screaming. Boychuk in the corner. Peverly chips it around to Kelly. Kelly back to Peverly. Catches it one-handed on the backhand. Deeks against Darsh. Works against Spachek. Peverly going wide. Ferentz in the middle. It goes past everybody to the near side boards. Travis Mullen lugs it up in front of the penalty bench. Eller trying to fight through traffic. Lucic the last man back. Scrambly play, and it goes end-to-end at TD Garden. David Krejci the diagonal through the neutral zone against Gill. Krejci wide, the shot, save, juicy rebound, comes all the way to the near boards. Eller wants transition. Up and down the ice they go. Eller works against Carvalet. Horton jumps in. McQuaid, it's Gill the drive, and it goes off of Darsh. Gill's never scored a goal in the playoffs. He's got the second longest streak of all time without having scored a playoff goal.
Now the Bruins going to slow the Canadiens down through the neutral zone, Jack. That's an area of concern right now. It was in the second period. It's again here in the fourth period.
Horton chops it clear and Krejci's got nothing left. The Bruins change out. PK Subban, a spring in his step to the attacking line, to Plekanec. Camilleri across the middle. Bergeron with back pressure. Plekanec chicken wings his stick, and on they go. Marchand chips the puck over to Recchi. He's got Seidenberg as the trailer. Recchi dances well. The shot saved by Price, and an attacking zone faceoff for the Bruins in sudden death overtime. Kelly wins the faceoff against Eller. Cabernet off the end board. Seidenberg around through the corner. Spacek bats it toward goal. Darsh wheels off Seidenberg's skate. And a Seidenberg indirect pass. Michael Ryder. Sopel, Spacek. Moen plays it off the skate, flips it on Thomas. Can of corn out of the air. Seidenberg with Moen hunting the puck. Seidenberg stumbles but gets the puck over to Peverly, to Kelly. The wrist shot and a save by Carey Price. Putting more emphasis on the draws. Halpern barging and getting thrown out. Plekanec and Krejci on the faceoff. Krejci wins it. Halpern jumps into the circle. Subban hard off the end boards. McQuaid pinches around. Camilleri all the way to the corner. Subban down there. McQuaid, the defenseman, all the way up forward, tries to trickle it middle. Subban can't whack it past McQuaid. Lucic, top of the circle. Horton, the drive, score! The Bruins knock out Montreal! Than a year after their most ignominious defeat, folding after leading Philadelphia 3-0. This Boston Bruins club does something that no team in the history of the franchise ever had in 26 previous similar situations, rallying from 0-2 down in a best-of-seven series to win it, finishing the Montreal Canadiens in sudden death in Game 7.
At the end of last year, Jack, the Bruins took a look at their club and said, we need some more goal scoring. They went out and acquired a guy named Nathan Horton. It hasn't been huge numbers for him during the regular season, nor has it been in the postseason. But I think he scored a couple of overtime goals here at the TD Garden. Absolutely huge for the Boston Bruins.
Carey Price, incredible after Boston scored its third goal. Tim Thomas, Zdeno Ochara, and the Boston Bruins get the 700-pound seventh-game gorilla off their backs once and for all.
It wasn't easy. They had it 3-2 late in regulation. A penalty to Patrice Bergeron, a power play goal by Subban, sent it to overtime. They couldn't extend their lead when they had it 3-2 because of the play of Carey Price. But they were determined. As a group, they said, those that were here a year ago, they learned their lesson. They would use it as motivation this year. And they get an opportunity in round one to start to prove that that is the case. And they delivered in an unbelievable series.
Nathan Horton from Milan Lucic and Adam McQuaid at 5:43 of overtime. And in series number 33 between these two great original six franchises, the Boston Bruins advance to the second round to meet, yes, the Philadelphia Flyers. Tim Thomas was ridiculous in the overtime period. He is live with Nauko Funayama at ice level. Nauko.
Thank you, Jack. Tim, Jack, just said you were absolutely ridiculous in this series. Take us through this overtime and the mindset going into it for you.
Well, I was just trying to play the same way I did in the other overtimes. You know, it's tough because they battled so hard and they just came back. You know, no matter tonight, every time we got ahead, they just kept coming back. I was doing everything that I could to keep it out, and they still were getting goals. So I didn't know for sure we were going to win going into overtime. You know, so I to be honest, I can't believe it's over. It's kind of surreal.
How does it speak to the resilience of this team to hang in there and win this game here tonight?
It speaks huge things. You know, like they never gave up, but we never gave up, and we came out on top. So that says even more about us.
Tim, congratulations on the win here today. Jack?
Now, Cole, thank you. You can tell Tim Thomas is skating on air down there. You can hear the adrenaline in his voice. Thrill of a lifetime for the members of this Boston Bruins team, and they had to scratch for every inch ice.
You can't underestimate how important this win is to this core group, to this management team, to this coaching staff, to all these players. This truly was a must-win situation, and to do it in the fashion that they did it, when you thought the game was in hand and it got away from them on a couple of occasions because of special teams play, but 5-on-5, the Bruins, I thought, were very good again tonight, and to win it in overtime in front of this packed house, it does speak volumes about this club that they are headed in the right direction. They do continue to progress, and of course they'll face a big challenge when they go to Philadelphia. But a nice pitch down the wall by Adam McQuaid. And how has he matured as a player, Jack? Just doing a terrific job, playing with confidence, learning the system, using his assets. And then Milan Lucic, again involved in the OT winner. A little deflection on that one-timer or the backup slap shot by Nathan Horton that beats Price low to the glove side. The celebration was on. But this is just a pivotal win for this Bruins team. A team where a lot of people in Boston were unsure if they could pull it off.
And just to reemphasize how much this goal means and how much those Tim Thomas saves meant in overtime, as you see Cam Neely, Peter Chiarelli, Jim Benning just about killing each other in celebration on the ninth floor on the bench. People had Claude Julien fired if the Bruins lose this game. But Boston advances to the second round, exerting its will.